Good morning. Welcome to St. Thomas More for our celebration of the third Sunday of Easter. Special welcome to anyone who might be visiting our parish. I'm Father Randy, I'm the pastor. I'll be the main celebrant, and I'm assisted by Deacon Zach. Brothers and sisters, in order to be an example of faith to others, we must observe and believe. To be a witness, you must first witness. My intention for this Mass as a celebrant is for the people of St. Thomas More Parish. In these moments, before we begin, I invite you to call to mind your own prayer intention for this Mass. To preserve the sacred nature of our liturgy, please silence your cell phones and electronic devices. I invite you to rise and greet those around you. Morning. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins
Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. May your people exalt forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that, rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the holy and righteous one and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." the word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, I know him, but do not keep his commandments are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Why did the belt go to jail? Because it held up a pair of pants. Oh, yeah. You want another one? All right. Why couldn't the bike stand up? It was too tired. Yeah. Now, we chuckle or groan at puns because we recognize that they're like a clever use of words. Sometimes just because words sound the same, or it could be the same word, it just has different meanings. We have this word witness. I think it could be understood five different ways. If I observe something, then I witness it. But then because I'm the one who observed it, I can become a witness. But then if I tell you about what I observed, I witness to you. We also have this understanding that if someone gives an example to someone else, that they're witnessing. But in doing that, they're also themselves a witness. Brothers and sisters, none of us would be seated in this church today if it wasn't for witnesses, right? We needed people who witnessed to what they witnessed, became witnesses so that all of us could witness the Catholic faith. Am I right? If we look at the gospel today, there's these disciples who encountered Jesus on the road to Emmaus. Right? So they witnessed the resurrected Lord. They became witnesses. They ran all the way back to Jerusalem to witness to their experience. And all of the apostles who witnessed the resurrection became the witnesses of our faith down through the generations, so that it's true. We can say, well, we witness what the apostles have told us, but not just them, right? The generations that are before us, our parents and our grandparents. What do we call it when someone witnesses to the Catholic faith amid persecution, even to the point where they might die for the faith? What do we call that person? Become a martyr, which is the Greek word for witness, right? So there's a lot of witnessing going on here. Are you a martyr? Are you willing to give witness to our Catholic faith amid persecution? Because it can be difficult. And maybe not just amid persecution, but like our own selfish desires kind of coming into conflict with what Jesus has taught us and the morality that the church gives us. A lot of times questions arise in our hearts, or we can even have doubt. In the gospel today, the apostles, are experiencing the resurrected Lord, and it says that they think that maybe he's a ghost, which makes sense because they know that he was crucified, and those who were there present, they saw him die. And so the question that arises, because Jesus says, why do questions arise in your hearts? Well, because we saw you die, and now you're here. I think there's a difference between questions arising in our hearts and doubting. If we have questions, then it kind of says that there's an assumption that there's an answer. Like, I have questions, but I assume that if I ask the right person, maybe someone's going to give me the answer. But if I have doubts, then it's more I'm on the side that I don't think that this is actually real. I don't think that there's going to be an answer. So the question of whether or not Jesus was a ghost, right, he answers it. He says, you can touch me, right? And do you have some fish? He eats some food in front of them, right? So he's very much the Lord who is risen. And then he reminds them, because their short-term memory isn't working, I preached about all of this stuff when I was alive before the crucifixion, that I would die and that I would rise. So what about us? Do we have questions in our hearts or do we doubt? What God invites us to do is to have faith in the witness that has come down to us from the apostles, and to, you know, if that he invites us to ask questions, and a lot of times many of our questions with a little bit of time and energy can actually be answered, but also to have faith that not everything is going to be answered on this side of heaven. He invites us to live our faith in this experience of a life of grace. So an exchange of love with God in prayer. He loves me. I love him in return. I receive the sacraments, especially confession and the Eucharist. And I live this life of grace with him, and that I would be a witness. Because when I witness my faith to others, it has this grace that comes back and strengthens my own faith. One of the ways that we witness to others is through our own generosity of resources. How we tithe, how we give alms, and how we provide for the needs of the local church. Like when we tithe here, it's true as what I've said is that, you know, it runs the parish here, but then we tithe on the tithe. We use 10% of the money that you tithe here to give to various statewide and national and international charities. But there are a lot of needs on an archdiocesan level, which is why every year we run a campaign that's called the Archbishop's Catholic Appeal. And so right now, I invite you to witness this year's video.
The first words spoken by Jesus in the Gospel of John. Within these words lies the core of our faith. An encounter, much like those who asked, "Master, where are you staying?" We too are invited to come and see. In the Eucharist, Jesus invites us into a transformative encounter, awakening and deepening our connection with him. What can you do when Christ is in you? Every action you take, each prayer you offer, and your generous gift to the appeal all mirror your encounter with Christ. Your contribution to the Archbishop's Catholic Appeal enables 9,000 students to experience the gift of Catholic education. Your gift offers shelter and essential resources to those experiencing homelessness. Through your support, Annunciation Heights becomes a haven for campers and families to connect with creation and deepen their faith. Your donation also empowers over 100 seminarians in our archdiocese to pursue their calling. It's through your generosity that our diocese continues to flourish, providing the sacraments and nurturing our faith community. Supporting our priests is essential to spreading the message and love of Christ. So, what are you looking for? What is it that will satisfy your soul's deepest need? It's the ongoing encounter with Christ in the Eucharist that transforms us. As we encounter Him, we learn to make our lives a gift for others, mirroring Jesus' self-giving. This is the essence of our faith, to encounter Him and be inspired to imitate His love and generosity. This journey flourishes with your support of the Archbishop's Catholic Appeal.
The gospel message of Jesus remains eternal. It is as true today as it was when He spoke the words 2,000 years ago, "Come and see," He says, calling each of us to conversion, inviting us to follow Him as His disciples, and to join in His rescue mission to save us all. You, yes, I am talking to you, even those in the back pew, I'm speaking to you. You matter to Jesus and have a critical part to play in His mission. As your Archbishop, I urge you to pray about how Jesus is inviting you to join His mission. Ask Him to show you how you matter in this. For many, that can include supporting the Archbishop's Catholic Appeal, which provides the necessary funding to our faith in action across the Archdiocese. I urge each and every one of you, because you are a part of the body of Christ, to participate, no matter how much or how little you may give. It is building the body of Christ and sharing in His mission that is most important. Thank you for your support, and God bless you.
We would like to thank the many families from our parish whose generous contributions towards last year's appeal helped us to achieve our parish goal. We would like an increase in the number of families who participate this year. For your convenience, you can complete our pledge today by filling out the information on the pledge envelopes found in the pew pockets. Or if you prefer, you can take it home and make your pledge online by visiting the Archdiocesan website listed on the pledge envelope or on the brochures. There will be a second basket sent around after our regular offertory for you to place the envelopes in. On behalf of Archbishop Aquila, Father Randy, and the many ministries and people who will be served by your generous gift, thank you for your timely support of the appeal.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Jesus did not want his disciples to remain troubled, so he assured them of his continuing presence. We now bring the needs that trouble us before the Lord, assured of God's presence with us.
For the Holy Catholic Church, that we may be witnesses to the risen Lord, revealing his presence in our acts of mercy and love to those in need. As a redeemed people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of the church, governments, and industries, that they will work together to free the oppressed, protect the vulnerable, and provide for the needy. As a redeemed people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who feel the absence of God and the burden of sin, that they will be filled with the presence and comfort of the risen Christ. As a redeemed people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our neighbors who are lifted up by Christ's sacrificial gift of the Eucharist and supported by this year's Archbishop's Catholic Appeal, that they will find renewed hope in their relationship with Jesus Christ. As a redeemed people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community, that we will be credible observers and give good witness to others. As a redeemed people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, that they will find comfort, peace, and healing in our Lord, who understands their suffering, especially baby Levi Atkinson, Al Lopez, Crystal Lopez, and for all who are listed in our book of prayer and healing. As a redeemed people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died as faithful witnesses to God's love in Christ, that they will see his face shining on them day after day in the heavenly kingdom, especially Yvonne Murray, Bob Prestera, Ronnie Rochal, Catherine Swayeka, Rob Teray, and for all the souls in purgatory. As a redeemed people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the intentions of the Holy Father, and for the prayers that we now offer in the silence of our hearts. As a redeemed people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty God and Father, you have extended to us the gift of salvation, promised to our ancestors. Hear our prayers and help us to live as faithful witnesses to Jesus. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. So right now, brothers and sisters, you can have a seat. The first basket that's going to come around now, the round basket, is our normal parish offertory basket. And then right after that, a rectangular basket will come around, and that's for the cards for the Archbishop's Catholic Appeal or for any contributions to the Archbishop's Catholic Appeal.
King of heaven, the glorious King, Lord.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously. When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, for he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Thomas More, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant, Francis our Pope and Samuel our Bishop, Jorge his assistant, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The Christ had to suffer and on the third day rise from the dead. In his name, repentance and remission of sins must be preached to all the nations. Alleluia. The Christ had to suffer and on the third day rise from the dead. In his name, repentance and remission of sins must be preached to all the nations. Alleluia. Worthy are you.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Nothing says I love you quite like a game of dodgeball between parents and their middle schoolers and high schoolers. So join our other families for some good, clean dodgeball fun with lots of laughter this evening in the school gym. We begin at 6:45 p.m. Refreshments will be served. You can see page 8 in the bulletin for more details. Please help to support women and infants in need by donating new or gently used baby clothes, bottles, and diapers to the annual St. Thomas More Stitchers Baby Shower for Infants. Donations will be accepted before and after all masses next weekend. See page 6 in the bulletin for more information. And it is with great excitement that we are now able to share with the community the name of the priest who will be assigned here coming this July 1st. It is Father Vitold Catchmagic. He is currently serving at Our Lady of Lourdes in St. Louis, and he will join the parish staff July 1st. We look forward to welcoming him to his new home.
Will the extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion going to the sick please come forward? You have been assigned to bring Jesus to those who are sick and unable to attend this liturgy. May nothing delay you. Assure them of our prayers for their health and recovery. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Saint Michael, the Archangel,